Rave About Africa in the Gambia 2016. Rave About Africa reps escorting 63 people from the UK to the Gambia. Many have never travelled to Africa before. How do they feel?
At a race, touchdown on the motherland now.
Remind me the first time I came.
What was that?
My heart was pumping. It's close. 2 minutes. 1 minute. Come on, open the door. Hurry up. I need to get out there. I need to feel the sun.
As you have seen on the plane, people are very excited, but also with feelings of fear.
Yes, sir. Rastafari, give thanks and praise. Back again in the Gambia. Big up to Rave About Africa. Ready to have a lovely time. So give thanks and praise, and see you along the journey.
The Mamalimbo Djembe drummers are there to greet the new arrivals from the plane with the Rave About Africa crew. Handouts and hotel bands are given out on the bus for the 25-minute journey to the hotel. This makes it easier for the check-ins once we arrive at the reception.
Is your neighbours?
This is Gambia, Mama Africa. You have to come.
Some guests have come for 2 weeks and some for just one. We speak to some of the guests who have already spent a week in the Gambia.
It's a real privilege. I feel on top of the world, to be honest with you.
I feel I'm not going back. I don't want to go back to England.
Here in Gambia, in Africa, the motherland, right? It's what I've been longing for, that peace. It's long overdue amongst my own black people.
For the first night, guests relax in the hotel and have an introduction to the finest African cuisine. There is also a fashion show where some of our guests volunteer to join the professional models in showcasing African fashion. Africa come from, and that is for sure. My proto women from, proto women from, in a Gambia me born, and that is for sure. My proto women from, proto women from. Our guests will also have an idea of the clothes they may wish to be made for our final night celebrating our African king and queen. After breakfast, on the first morning, Rave About Africa hosts a welcome meeting where travellers can introduce themselves and meet and greet other like-minded travellers who have come to Africa.
I'm here because I'm on an independent journey to really deepen my understanding of who I am and my connection to this wonderful, amazing continent.
For me, the feeling of being free is important because the legacy of colonialism is just so recent for my family. So
my best experience about Africa itself, it is to put to bed all of the lies and the whitewashing that I've heard all of my life.
I'm going to embrace the whole experience, and it's good to be able to embrace it with you guys.
I came back again to meet similar-minded people, because believe it or not, in London, I don't talk to many people because their mind seems to be in a different place to where my mind is. So I came here again to meet people who are on the same wavelength that I was.
You know, everything take a time, and this is my time now. A long time I talk about Africa and tune and music, and you know, you have that vibe about it, but never reach, and it's, you know, for me time now. So we're there for just enjoy it, and hope everybody else can enjoy it too, you know.
From the age of our own,
not heard that
by in our early teens, where is it? In our early teens, back in the 70s, okay. Is a place where we dream about, fantasize about coming to Africa, and from the land yesterday. Ah, me Japanese. Why me there, you know? There.
You're going to like it. You're going to love it. You're going to come back again.
Everyone has been given an itinerary of the week long of events, which include theme nights, school visit, the two-day reggae beach festival celebrating the life and times of Bob Marley, an overnight trip to Albreda, Jeffrey and Kunte Kinte Island, and workshops.
Now the island you'll find is corroding. It's getting smaller and smaller. So unless something is done, it actually will not exist in years to come. Yeah. And then when we've gone to the island, which the island is on small boats, only about 15-minute boat ride from Jeffrey, we're going to go back to Albreda and Jeffrey, have some lunch, and then we come back. We'll be back at the hotel at probably the latest 4 o'clock. Yeah, so we're going to leave here on Monday at 11:30 in the morning. Okay?
Rave About Africa will also be hosting a two-day reggae beach festival. There will be Gambian and international artists. Artists include special guests Gappy Ranks and Christopher Ellis.
Guess who's coming on stage? My brother!
Yo, yo!
My brother! Gappy Ranks!
I keep coming from my generation. When artists are bringing to my education. Leaders of the world and the United Nations. Never was hear the message by the radio station. No one's a ghetto youth, me have a reputation. I reach it West Indian, but me born in England. Father Jamaican, mama. And deep in me yard, me a real African.
I'm still in love.
Gambia!
With...
I know you know this song. I know you know this lyric, so please sing it again.
Mad move.
I said in 1967, Papa said me write this one.
Before you buy.
Said I am still in the love. With you, everybody knows and everybody knows.
We also host a property presentation and Q&A for those who wish to buy property or land within the Gambia.
For every plot that we are selling, we have the mortgage system and we have the cash payment system. And we have lands in almost the most important places in the Gambia. The places that are very, very accommodating, and they are very flexible and accommodating for visitors.
What's the best way of protecting your land once it's secured, it's demarcated, and if you're living in the UK and you don't intend to come to Gambia for maybe a few months or a year?
All what you need to do, you can fence it and leave it. Even if you don't want to build anything, just fence it there, leave it like that.
The average appreciation yearly of a property in a prime area.
The locations differ. For example, if it is Kerseri, it's a place where many people in the Gambia wants to live. If I should purchase for a plot of land, empty plot of land, for $1 million, expect in the next 5 years, you can sell it for $3 to $4 million.
We're at Aquarius, as you can see, cafe or nightclub, and it's our African King and Queen night. Now, every time we do trips to the Gambia or to other places in Africa, we have African King and Queen night where everyone orders or creates clothes with African material and fabrics and wears them on the last night before we go home.
I'm here as a guest and a fan. Rave About Africa. They put on the best tours, the best day trips, and we're here at Aquarius on our last night before they go home. Brilliant time. Rave About Africa.
Rave About Africa.
Woo!
Woo-hoo!
Okay.
Line up. Everybody line up.
I'd like to say thank you to everybody who came out on this trip from England, from Birmingham, Bristol, London. The Birmingham Massive! The London Massive! Okay. The Bristol Massive! And anywhere else! And the Gambia Massive! We are Rave About Africa, and probably people in the Gambia have heard of us. We've had a week of programs. We've had a two-day beach party. We've had Gappy Rants. We've had Christopher Ellis. We went to Jeffrey Island today, and we made history. The whole of Jeffrey came out to greet us last night. And we are the only group that has spent an overnight in Jeffrey. And we had naming ceremony, renewal of vow ceremony, and all the tribes together, for the first time I'm told, came together and danced and celebrated with us. An Iman in Jeffrey is 74 years old. And he said, from he was a little boy, he has never, and I'm right because you're from Japan, he has never seen a celebration as they celebrated with us today. So I thank everybody who came to Jeffrey with us yesterday and overnight. We made history. And I clap, everybody who came to Jeffrey. A big hand to you all. Okay, this is our last night party. And the Rave About Africa crew, all the DJs from the UK, the DJs from the Gambia, all the Rex and Clive, Mr. Cameraman, all of you guys, I thank you. And I thank you guys that booked with us. And I know that a lot of you have said, we're coming back with you guys, we're coming back. So all I'll say is have a good night tonight, because we're traveling back tomorrow.
Rave About Africa, let's do this. Otis, are you ready? Come on. Hey. Party, we're saying, yeah, man, look good, feel good, like you should. Wanda, we want this to come in. So I'm gonna stay there. Yo! Come on, we're gonna dance out, we're gonna so fly.
It's the first time we go anywhere and so much people out just to say, you know, bye and wave into we and things like that. We travel together all over the place, and sometimes we leave and the country not even knows that we gone. But these people, them genuinely love we and greet we and say goodbye to we, like family. And respect to them.
We got the whole of the red group doing, you understand? And I know they're gonna continue doing it for many more years, and then to build up the whole vibe in a Gambia. Rave About Africa. Bill Park, you're pronouncing that. About.
I wanna say thank you to you and all the organizers for bringing me here. My first time in Africa, it's been amazing.
There's so much people that's struggling, you know, it's like they don't see no light, and I'm still happy. And some of we attitude bad because we in a luxury. We not satisfied with life. We just broke bad. You know, we need to satisfy with life and not watch other people with what them have. Because we don't know what them get it.
I can't describe it. Other than, you know, when you come off the plane, there's something that's like home, a home you've never been to. That's basically what it is, a home you've never seen, never been to before, and you get off the plane and you just feel like you're at home. It's nice to see a load of white Europeans in Europe, that's how the Europeans must feel when they see each other. And when I come here and I see my brothers here in Africa, in the continent, it feels really nice. Very welcoming. And all this coming over to Africa and all you see is starving children with flies in their nose and nothing to eat and no future. No, I haven't seen anything like that here. And I've been around Gambia and seen the people.
Gambia, we no differentiate Muslim and Christian, you know. All we are one, we are equal. We believe that we have different religion, but we all believe in the same thing, man, you know. One God, you know. It's all about that, you know. Yeah, you can't differentiate, say this guy is a Muslim or this guy is a Christian. No, we don't do that, you know, in Gambia. And we eat together, we do things together, we school together, you know, we sit and chat and we do things, you know. When is the Muslim festival, you see, what are we go out, we chill, you know. Both Muslim and Christians join together and enjoy it, you know. When is the Christmas, you see both Muslims and Christians join together and go and celebrate, you know. That's how we do it here, you know.
One people,
different Africa. From other African countries, you know what I mean, you know. Different like from the north, you know. This is the west side, the best part to be, you know what I mean?
All right.
Big up, man. Slash, yeah. Man. You know. That's the fire. Yeah, man.
So everything is nice, man. It's relaxing. It's adventurous. We went to the school earlier on, which was very, very moving. You know, just to see how the children, how they sang and they embraced us. And there was one particular young person who was, he was just full of lyrics, man. He spoke about culture, he spoke about his education and what he wants to achieve in life, but he was so positive. He reminded me of a young person who was working towards presidency. He was so intelligent.
Well, absolutely wonderful. Every second, every minute of it is just wonderful. Yeah.
Well, I'm connecting with the rest of the world from right in the heart of the Gambia, and I'm having an amazing conversation with my two girls on the other side of the world.
Free my chains and let me go. Oh, now, finally, I'm tell Babylon, we say, yo, yo, humble on us, no man, no better than a man. Govern on us, because you're the only land. Pacify and touch and make me burn a Babylon. Move down from a spear, shield man. So tell the politician to go to the position. Poor people, they must suffer, treat them like a magician. The prison, they must feel up like a water in a tank. It's hard to live your life and to survive.